this is an event with a heart. It shows a difference for your radio stations in the community that we're in. And I think this event has really been amazing, what you've done over the last few years. $1.3 million in change last year.
Every year, more and more success stories. Unfortunately, we still have some that don't work out quite as happily, and that's what we're trying to change. We're trying to make as many success stories as possible.
When it rains, it pours and opens doors that flood the floors with all but always keep us safe and dry.
You know, they're saying kids being here months. There's kids that go to school here. They might do a year or two of their education. Sometimes there are various diseases and conditions. They can't leave. They've got to be here.
Before there wasn't a hope. Michaela was a ticking time bomb. And with the citral anemia, it's very rare. There's only three kids here in Edmonton with it. And she now has hope. And you just, I don't know what to say. Like, what do you say to a doctor who gives you your life back?
Never in a million years. You don't ever dream that a four-year-old boy is going to come up with something like cancer.
Emma's an amazing little girl, and we have her because of the Stollery Children's Hospital.
I've figured out that how important the Stollery is. It's not just the cardiac ward that your child could be going to or anything like that. Adam had access to at least 45 different departments in this hospital. 45 services for one child in order to get that child well is just phenomenal.
I was sitting in the backyard 4 years ago and I listened to that first Radiothon and never once thought that I would have to use it. Honestly, did not think that I would ever have to use a facility like this.
And you're going to be using it the rest of your life?
Yes.
Of sad stories, but there's a lot of hope here.
Yes, there are.
You hear these sad stories, but there are so many success stories coming out of this place.
There is more success every year, but until it's all success, we've got to keep going because we don't want to see any of the kids, you know, crying, not understanding what's going on, getting sick, not be able to lead a normal life, have no hope. They don't understand.
They're kids.
Yeah. And they shouldn't be in here. They shouldn't sound like a doctor with a medical degree explaining to you surgeries and medications and all this other stuff. They should be kids playing in the park.
And we are hoping against hope. Certainly we're not closing the phones yet by any stretch. So do continue to make your calls. We're hoping that the first total that goes on that board is just so, so good.
It's 6:55. We got 5 minutes to go. Here comes the total. They're writing it up on the board right now.
407-5437, 407. Kids, the phone lines will be open till 7:15. Let's see what it's going to be. The total unofficially at 6:55, which it is right about now, 6:55.
We need, okay, we've got a 1, 0, 0, 0, so we're up to $1,000. We're up to $1,000, Sid, obviously. We're up to $1,000.
Well, they're keeping the
suspense up. I know, they're making me nuts. I'm going to throw something at somebody in about 2 minutes.
No, I'm getting excited. I want to see a whole bunch more numbers.
Edmonton, this is what you and surrounding area and everybody who donated, this is what you did, okay? They're slowly but surely writing the grand total up on here.
Thank you so much.
Phone lines everything. Until 7:15.
Oh.
1.421 million.
Yes! 1,421,000.
All right!
Are you kidding me?
Thank you, Edmonton.
Really is that any good?
Preliminary total, everybody. We're at $1.4
million. $1,421,000.
It's great that we hit $1,421,000. In fact, it's unbelievable.
Last year, we hit the $1.3 million mark, and I just didn't think we'd be able to do it again. And here we are already over $1.4 million.
You know, I'm never surprised by the City of Edmonton. They come through every time, and this is one of the best causes. When people give, it's not like they're giving to us.
I think the highlight for me personally, aside from raising that money, was meeting all the families and the wonderful kids. You get to see in real life what you're raising the money for and who you're doing it for.
It happened to me last year with about four or five specific children, and it happened again this year, so my total is going to increase every year, and I'm going to have kids that I'm going to watch grow up, and I'm going to watch get healthy because of you.
Or on behalf of all of the kids that have to spend nights here at this hospital with their parents, and all of the ones yet to come, thank you so much for giving to the Stollery Children's Hospital Radiothon.